Appreciate you coming out this way. So thankful for another opportunity to assemble together here, worship the Lord today, and I hope, pray, that's what we do. We missed Wednesday night. Boy, I tell you, we had a sweet service here Wednesday night. Wonderful time in the house of the Lord. Just a sweet spirit. Good testifying. Good singing. Started out old Heather. She had a song on her heart. Choir singing. Boy, the Lord just moved upon me on the words of that song. It blessed me. People went to testifying and singing other songs. And so good. Well, Vicky, he jumped up fire and sung out, "I can't make it without you." Is that the name of it? I'm off with the names of songs. My goodness. What a sweet service. When people obey the Lord and do what God tells them to, and they've got a song on their heart, and they've got a testimony. Thinking back last Sunday morning, I'm sure coming up here this altar, getting up and praising the Lord, thanking God for being saved. Well, God was really moving here last Sunday morning. We had a great service, but it could have been a wonderful service. I feel like at some point in that service, people quench the Spirit. That's what we can't do. I promise you one thing this morning. I'm going to be honest with you about this. If the Holy Spirit is moving on you to do something, it's right. And it's for a reason. It's for a purpose. God has a song on your heart, a testimony, a word of Scripture, preaching, shout. You need to mind the Lord and obey God and do what God would have you to do. Be the best thing that you ever do. There's nothing quite like going home from a good service and knowing that you've obeyed the Lord and God just blessed you unreal. It may be just to sit there and let the tears flow and just praise the Lord from your heart. That's what God wants you to do. God wants you to pray. And you just mind the Lord. It'll be the best thing that you ever do. Boy, I'm excited and looking forward to the service today. Continue to pray for the tent revival in Andrews. God's moving over in a mighty way. Saving people. We've seen some miraculous things happen. I think I've got to go 3 nights. I went by after it's over last night. I've been out and come back through that way and stopped by there and talked to them a pretty good while. They had a wonderful service last night. But continue to pray for that. Continue to pray for Laura May. Lift her up to the Lord. They're going to do an MRI tomorrow. Maybe they can find out exactly what's giving her all this pain. She's hurting so terribly bad. She's doing better here the last few days. She's doing a little better. She's still in the hospital. Continue to pray for her. Pray for this service this morning that the Lord would have His way. Pray that we'd see somebody saved. And pray for the same, testifying, preaching the Word here this morning. We love you. I mean that. And I just hope and pray that everybody leaves here today blessed by the Lord. We can leave here excited about what God's done and what God's going to do. I'm so thankful and I'm reminded. Amen. Just hold one of these precious youngies for a little while. Think about if serving God is worth it or not. Amen. We got little ones that's watching us.
Amen.
And I promise you one thing, it's worth it. The Lord ain't come back yet, so this thing ain't over. And I promise you, the church ain't dead. We may act like it sometime. But if we're saved, we have the power of resurrection in us. And according to the Word of God, we can be more than conquerors through Him. America's in trouble. We need to turn back to God. And we need to in a bad way. That's the only thing that's truly going to make a difference in this country. Is if people will repent of their sins. And they'll come back to God. And I believe with all my heart that we need to pray for our country. Appreciate Tyler standing in this morning and Jerry's absence. Gary and Pauline's gone on vacation. He sent me one of the most beautiful sunrises you ever seen this morning. I know we're having a good time. We appreciate Tyler. Appreciate all our other ones that's willing to teach and preach. Appreciate Eddie helping me the last Sunday night. And I was gone. Thankful for that. We're just so thankful for our teachers, for our deacons. Thankful for our church. On everybody that will, let's give around the altar this morning. Go to the Lord in prayer. Pray much for this service. Get up in this choir. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Mike Schuler family, Mike passed away. They'll be having his funeral today. Brother Coy will be helping in that. Pray much that God will save souls in that place. Let's pray. Father, Lord, as we come before you here this morning, as we come to God, as we know how. Thank you for another opportunity to be in your house. What a privilege, what a blessing, God, that it is. Lord, I pray, God, that you receive this out of ourselves. Help us to set our affection truly and wholly upon you, that we might look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Lord, I pray, God, that you manifest your spirit here in this place this morning. God, that you move in our midst, and Lord, that your will be done. Lord, I pray you draw the lost to repentance, God. Restore the backslider, encourage, God, that saint, Lord, that's so weak and so tired. God, they've been fighting so hard and trying so hard. Lord, I pray that your spirit would refresh them and revive them. Lord, I pray, God, for just a good, humble spirit to be awakened here today. Lord, we've got young people, Lord, that they don't understand the way of salvation. Lord, it's going to take your spirit, God, making it real, making it clear to them. God, I pray that the Holy Spirit, God, would manifest to each one of those. Lord, that you would speak to their heart. God, I pray, Lord, that you'd bless this service, God. Bless the singing, God, the testifying. Lord, I pray, God, that you'd put it on those hearts, God, that you'd have to do something for you today. Lord, I ask you, God, to empty us out of self. And God, just fill us up, Lord, with you. God, I pray, Lord, when we get full of you, Lord, there's room for nothing else. Lord, I pray, God, Lord, have your way. Lord, we'll be sure to thank you and praise you, God, for all you do. Lord, bless these little children. God, we've got so many here in the church. Lord, I go so many places and they don't have a young one. God, we thank you for our youngins. Lord, we pray, God, that we'd help, Lord, bring them to you. And Lord, not God do anything, God, that would turn them away from you. Lord, we pray, God, that you'd put your hand upon each one of them and bless them, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All that will come up to the choir. Let's make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Dire back and sing for the Lord this morning. Sing like you mean. Praise God. Thank you.
choir sing the verses, and the choir back her up on the chorus. She knows every word for it.
Bless them, good Lord.
I'm glad I'm free. And the sunset's free. Thy born is free indeed.
Faith out of the Thanksgiving cheer everywhere and put Sam Mountain. And I just thank God today that he's been in the Word of God for 32 years of church. We've seen a lot of sadness. We've seen you come out and cry. The heart's broken. We don't see that a whole lot, but Steve, we just thank God that that's what he chose to be. And I thank God that he gave me space to love. And I love his church, too. We still don't use us that love. Before I got saved, I thought I loved people, but after I got saved, I'm going to love everyone.
Bless you, Miss God.
Blessed, those
lost
were blessed
and they were saved. You will if you say it. You don't always have to like everybody's way, but you'll love them. Down deep in, you'll forgive them. Praise God, that's right. That ain't a popular message, is it? You'll forgive them. Amen. God help us.
Oh, God, death's the hope, my friend.
Thank you.
baby. Thank you, Lord. I'm the Lord this morning. He's working. Give him praise. Altars are open. Praise God. Amen. I stand to the faith. Fellowship on the
swept him up and rushed him back there and started to pass on him. And And all kinds of tests, they get to find anything wrong with him. We went down this evening, sent him in the hospital, took him a little candy, and bought him a little helicopter, and made him about tore that hospital room apart, playing that helicopter. He was feeling better. His daddy said, well, that's the first time I've seen him smile all day. I had him up in that bed, he was about to jerk his IV out. He was up, boy, he's pulling that string, flying that helicopter, he's having a good time. What really tickled me is he refused. He's, this may be too sensitive for some of you, I don't know, you need to get over it if it is. He's just a little boy and he refused. He likes to pee outside at home. That's what he feels comfortable, he just goes outside and pee. He refused to pee in that hospital. So his daddy had to take him out in the parking lot and he peed on a bush out there in front of him. Lord, I love that youngin', son. He's my buddy, I'm telling you, he's a dandy, but talked to his daddy this morning and Lord willing, he ought to get to go home. Maybe already he is. We're supposed to get to go home this morning. So thank you for your prayers for him. Boy, I tell you, I love the precious children. How precious children are. I believe there's some things you can look at and find out where you stand with God. If you don't like children, say something wrong. Amen? I can examine a church, and when things are right and people's right with God, by how long they linger after the service. When people stand around the parking lot, fellowship and talking, don't want to go home, that's what it was Wednesday night after the service. We finally left and people were still out there talking. When you come in and everybody's talking and everything feels good, it's so important that we have fellowship with one another. God help us to do that. God help us to love Him and love one another. Like I said, we're not always going to agree. Sometimes it's better for two people not to be around each other. Sometimes you just don't, you're not like-minded with somebody. But you can still love them. And if you're both mature Christians, you can just say, hey, it's better off that we just ignore them. But you got to make amends. Got to get your peace with God. Got to get peace with each other. And go on with your life. That's what you've got to do. There's people right now, I love them with all my heart. It's best for me just not to be around them. We do not agree. We're not like-minded. I wish no ill towards them. We don't have the same values. We don't have anything in common. It's better off. We just don't communicate like that. Say hey, smile, and go on your way. Amen. God help us. God help us. You have your Bible, you can turn with me to Matthew chapter 16 this morning. Matthew chapter number 16. Boy, just continue to pray for Laura May and lift her up. How urgent and pressing that's been on my heart the last few days. If you'd have seen her down there at that nursing home the other day, I'm telling you, I've seen that woman. I've seen her up there in high school. Me and Amy go up there, and she was up there for well over a month. That one time, wasn't she, D.D., a few years ago? I've seen her where she couldn't walk from her chair to her bedroom with oxygen on because she couldn't breathe. I've seen her up there in high school a while back. I got down and tried to help the nurse get them compression socks pulled up on her. Her legs were swelled up so big they couldn't get them socks on her. I got down and helped, and I've never heard that woman complain about one thing till the other day. She sat there and squeezed my hand. I got down on my knees and I prayed. The whole time she said, help me, Jesus. Oh, I'm hurting, Jesus. Big tears rolling down her cheeks. What broke my heart? So I urge you, church. She's been faithful and committed to this church for years upon years. I urge you to pray for her multiple times a day when she comes to your heart. Call her name out to the Lord. Ask God to touch her, to comfort her, to heal her. God's will be done. Matthew chapter 16, starting in verse number 13. The Bible says this. When Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, He asked His disciples, saying, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man am. And they said, some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. He says unto them, but whom say ye that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Then charged he his disciples that they should tell no man that he was Jesus the Christ. I want to preach today, if God will be my helper. I want to try to preach as quickly as I can. Simple message. And I want to ask you a question. Probably the greatest question that you'll ever have to answer. The most serious question that you'll ever hear. It's a very simple question, but I simply want to ask you, what think ye of Christ? I'm not asking you what say ye of Christ. What think ye of Christ? In your heart, in your mind, who is Jesus to you? Who is Jesus really to you? And I'll say here this morning, I'll say here today, that our actions speak louder than our words. Appreciate the wonderful message by Tyler this morning talking about those fruits of the Spirit. The singing lined up with it. Ed gave a wonderful message in the choir. We then sang Because He Lives. Because He Lives, I can face tomorrow. He is Christ. He is our hope. He is our Savior, Lisa. He's our friend. He's our guide. There's nobody like Jesus. But He's our Lord, if you'll have it. That means He rules and reigns over our life. That means that we are no longer our own. That's what the Scripture teaches. I want to ask you if you're aware of the Scripture this morning. Do you realize that the Bible teaches that we have been bought with a price? We are no longer our own. But if we are truly saved and a child of God, been born again, washed in the precious blood of the Lamb, that's the price we were bought with, we belong to God. We are His. We're now His servants. God help us to serve Him the way we should. Let us pray. Father, Lord, as we come before You this morning, as humbly, God, as I know how, I thank You, God, for the Holy Scripture. I thank You, God, for Your Word, Lord, that You teach us, God. And Lord, we know, God, that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. We know, God, that this Word is Jesus, Lord, and that it's alive. Father, I pray, God, that You'd anoint the lips of this Thy servant, God, that You'd help us to preach. God, I pray that You'd touch us. God, I pray, Lord, that You'd fill us, Lord, with Your precious Holy Spirit. Lord, I pray, O God in heaven, Father, I ask You right now, God, that Your will be done. Lord, in the remainder of this service, I pray You'd draw the lost, God, unto You. Lord, I pray, God, that You'd restore the backslider, God, that one, Lord, this morning. God, they're unwilling to admit right now they're not right with You. Lord, they're truly saved. God, they love You and they've tried their best to live for You. But God, right now, they'll not admit that their heart's not right. And Lord, if we will not admit to You, we'll never confess. And God, we must admit it to ourselves, Lord. And God, I pray You'd help us here this morning for just a little while. And God, that Your will be done in the remainder of this service. Lord, we love You and thank You. God, save our lost people, Lord. I pray You'd save a multitude here this morning. God, it'd be wonderful, Lord, to see everybody, Lord, that was lost, God, come down and cry out to You and be saved, God. Lord, pride will
will stop any of them. Oh God, I pray today, Lord, God, that your spirit would get so strong and so real speaking to them. God, that you would, Lord, that you just overpower, God, anything that comes against them. That's the devil tries to tell them today. Oh, that they've got plenty of time. Lord, I pray, God, that they refuse to listen to his lies any longer. That they realize that eternity is forever. How that life is short and hell is hot. Lord, I pray this morning, God, that you'd open the hearts and minds of those, God, that do not believe, or their eyes are blinded, they cannot see, God. Lord, I pray that glorious light of the gospel would shine unto them. God, those that have been going through the form and religion of the motions of religion, God. There's nothing more than church members, God. They sit on a pew, but God, they've never been born again. I pray they get so miserable, Lord. I pray, God, that you'd get a hold of them, Father. Lord, there'll be many stand before you in that day and cry out, Lord, Lord, oh, did we not do this? Did we not do that? And you'll say, depart from me, you worker of iniquity, for I never knew you. Lord, I pray today, God, that not only do we know you, but you know us. God, that we're known of you. I pray the demons know who we are. I pray that hell knows who we are. God, help us to be a Christian with an impact. A true Christian with a changed life. A new creature that we heard about this morning. God, help us, Lord. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Who do you say that I am? He asked the disciples that day. Now these were the men that were supposedly the closest to Jesus as anybody else. They laid down with him of a night. They slept, no doubt, in the same places. They ate in the same places. They went and ministered. They traveled together. They practically lived and walked together for 3 years. And he asked these men, he says, who do you say that I am? I don't care how long you've been walking with him, how much you know about him, what you can say about him. What do you think about him? In your heart and in your mind, are you truly a child of God? Have you truly been born again? I'm going to be honest. I'll tell you what tires me all to pieces. As a pastor, as a preacher, as a Christian. It ought to tire a Christian all to pieces. I'm very thankful for what we've seen in our country. But I'm going to be honest. People get mad over a beer. They get mad over a shopping store. They get mad over a country music song. Amen. Anywhere you want to, you can say, that's right, preacher. Without thinking 1 minute about how we've hurt God and how we've offended God with our Christless lifestyle. We are to be the salt of the earth. We are to be the light of the world. We are to be a new creature. My friends, it would be amazing if I seen as many posts on Facebook about God as I do about a country music song that ruffled little feathers. I'm going to go ahead and tell you something about this far left liberal woke crowd. You can't do nothing with them. You got to just let them go on. Let them be who they are and keep being who you are in Christ Jesus. Amen. This cancel culture, they call it, if somebody does something they don't agree with, they say offends them, they try their best to block them out, mark them out. Our former president, Donald Trump, they hate that man with a passion because he stands for truth. He stands for what's right. He tried to help our country. He loves America. He's tried his best. And I had a good friend that spoke face to face with him the other day, shook his hand and asked him if he had ever been born again, if he was saved, and if he knew Jesus. And he told my friend right square in the eyes, yes, I know Jesus. Yes, I've been saved. No wonder the world hates him. Yeah. Jesus said, if they hated me, they'll hate you too. My friend, we've got too many people professing to know Christ that never makes a ripple in the water. My friend, I want you to know this morning, if you are a true follower of Jesus Christ, according to the Word of God, all those that live godly in Christ Jesus shall. Not might, not maybe, not someday, possibly could. Shall
suffer persecution. My friend, if you are living godly for Christ Jesus, somebody's not going to like it. There are demons and devils of hell in this world. We are around demon-possessed people every day. You can drive to Blairsville now. I applaud Blairsville for not hiding it. Our little old commission meeting down here, and I thank the ones of you that voted against him. But I know who that wicked crowd was down there about night four, and applaud him. It's an abortion pill is what it is. They've got it on a sign down here going to Blairsville. Big, huge purple billboard. Pregnant with a question mark. Abortion pill in even bigger letters. Call us. We'll give you the info. You make the decision. This world is wicked. Amen. It is getting farther and farther away from God each and every single day. People are turning from God. We get mad because of what a beer company does. We get mad because of extremely liberal that most of us that care anything about anything has known was liberal for a long time, but they start putting pride stuff out there for little children, and it's made by a satanic producer. And I'm going to go ahead and break his heart about Disney, amen. Disney is wicked. We need to call a light to it. They refuse to produce or promote this movie, amen, about this child trafficking. They would not do it. But yet they promote a movie, amen, where a young girl gets pregnant by the devil in a fornication situation. Yeah, they're wicked. They've been pushing stuff on our youngins for a long time. It's time that we open our eyes. It's time that we stand for Christ. It's time that we say who He is. The Bible says, plainly teaches, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. My friends, if Christ is not in your heart, we've heard about the spirit relationship with the Lord. The Spirit is God in spirit. Jesus was God in flesh. And God is God the Father. My friend, that Spirit, when you get truly born again, it lives inside of you. You are a new creation in Christ Jesus. You are a child of God. You will be different. My friend, I'm telling you, you can quench, you can grieve the Spirit of God, but I want you to know, if you're a true believer and a true follower of Jesus Christ, you will have to take a stand at some time in your life. You will not be able to sit on the sidelines forever. You'll have to say, I can't go along with this. I don't agree with this. If not, you are hurting the cause of Christ. You are hurting the church. One reason the church is so weak today, one reason we don't see more people saved than what we should, is because we've lost our power with God, because we go along with every ungodly, worldly thing that there is, and we have little to no voice for God. My friend, it's time that we speak for God. Who? What think you of Christ? Who do you say that Christ is? I say He's a life changer. I say He's the one that can take an old drunk, an old whoremonger, an old dope addict, one that can take the vilest, most wretched, that can take a murderer. We heard the testimony of Brother Robert Gibson here last fall. One that can take a life that's so wrecked and savage by sin. He's the one, amen, that can wash in His blood. The old preacher said, I don't see how a black cow can eat green grass and make white milk. It's even more marvelous to me how a mighty God can take a black heart and a black soul full of black sin and wash it whiter than snow. Praise His holy name. But that's Him, amen. My God is a life-changing God. We've sat silent in the church too long. We've patted these little professions on the back. We act like everybody's saved. Oh, we give them a VBS attendance. Oh, we baptize them and never see them again for 30 years. Oh, yeah, they're all right. No, my friends, there's something wrong. God help us. What, thank you, Christ? You don't think Christ is big enough to still change lives? I meet no one in this Bible that he ever touched or encountered that was ever the same. When he changes you, it's for good. It's for life. Praise his holy name. You too can stand and sing with me. Lord, you're the best thing that's ever happened to me. Oh, our churches are too silent. We're too quiet for the Lord. What thank you, Christ? Oh, Peter, he couldn't help but say it. He said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." I'm telling you, my friend, the other disciples sat there that day. Some said, "Well, some say you're John the Baptist. Some say you're Elijah. Some say you're Jeremiah or another great prophet." But old Peter, praise God, he hit the nail on the head. "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." Praise his holy name. What's your testimony? What thank you of Christ? Are you saved? Are you lost? Do you know you're lost? If God's ever dealt with you, my friend, you're living on dangerous ground. If you know today that you're lost and you've never been saved, my friend, you're one breath away. As Samuel put it, you're one step away from death. It is appointed unto man once to die, and after this, the judgment. This thing is real. Hell is hot. What thank you of Christ? What thank you of the man that saved your soul? What thank you of the man that changed you? The man that loved you? The man that died for you and shed his blood for you? Has it become a fairy tale to us? What he done for us, what shall we do for him? Can I live for him? Can I give my life to him? Can I tell somebody about him? Can I love him with all my heart? The greatest commandment. Oh my goodness, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, all thy mind, all thy soul. Love thy neighbor as thyself. He said on those two things you can hang all the law and all the commandments. If we'll do those two things, if we'll love God and we'll do Matthew 6:33, we'll seek Him first and we'll put Him above everything else. If we'll do that, He said He'll add all things unto us. If we'll love God and love our neighbor, we'll not steal, we'll not lie, we'll not cheat, we'll not adulterate, we'll not fornicate, we'll not murder. If we love God and we love our neighbor, what thank you of Christ? If you love God, you love your mom and daddy. You'll respect them. You'll quit being a rebellious child like I was. I love my parents now. I love them. I thank God for them. Sure, they're human like I am. They make mistakes, still do, and I do too. And I love them and respect them. They gave me something. They gave me life. Not for them, I wouldn't be here. Above that, I've got a Heavenly Father who gave me life. Not for Him, I wouldn't be here. I love my Father. My Heavenly Father, and I respect Him, and I'm thankful for Him. What thank you of Christ? Who do you say that He is? There's no way. There's no way, according to this Bible, that you can be a true believer in love with God, walking in that Spirit, and agree with this world. Jesus said, "How shall two walk together except they be agreed?" I have no agreement with this world other than I would love to see them saved. They don't want to be. They're lost in their sin. They're blinded according to the Scriptures in 2 Corinthians chapter 4. The Bible says if our gospel be hid, it's hid to them that are lost. Because of God, little Jesus, this world has blinded the minds of them who believe not. Many are simply lost in their sin. Many have been turned over to a reprobate mind. I can't declare all those that are reprobate. As God's doing, I have some guidelines to go by in His Word that shows me and teaches me. There's many that have had their conscience seared with a hot iron. They do not retain God in their knowledge. Their thoughts, their works, their actions, their minds are continually wicked before God. You know how I know I wasn't a reprobate? When I was deep in sin, I was still ashamed of it. I tried to hide it. I tried to cover it. But when people blatantly, openly, grave their sin, I have no remorse. They're walking on dangerous ground. What thank you, Christ? Do you think enough of Him to tell your friend that she knows lost? Or is it going to make that situation uncomfortable? Do you think enough of Him to speak His name in a public place even though it won't be popular? Do you think enough of Him to live for Christ at school, youngins? Dane, Avery? Young people? Colson? Don't you ever be ashamed of Jesus, son. I believe with all my heart you'll live for God. I really do. I want our young people to live for God, Ethan. Down in our schoolhouse, you live for God. You don't have to do what everybody else is doing. They're cussing, you don't have to cuss. They drink a beer on a Friday night, you don't have to. You don't have to smoke that joint. You don't have to have sex before marriage. You keep yourself pure and save yourself for the mate that God puts in your life. What think you of Christ? If you think enough of Christ, you'll live for Him. You'll love Him. You'll serve Him. The reason why so many don't think much of Christ is because we are living. And I'm teaching on it right now. If you're very bit interested in it, Sunday nights and Wednesday nights you can come, but we're on the Life Church now. And if you want some meat, I encourage you to get out the house of God on Sunday nights and Wednesday nights. I've been teaching for the longest time on the seven churches of Revelation, and we're in that last one right now, that Laodicean church. Well, we believe that many of them were just churchgoers, but had never been converted. We firmly believe with all of our heart that churches sitting full of people today that have never truly been born again. I'm talking about the change. Do you believe the Bible? That's what it teaches. Change. That blind man, the Bible ever tell us anywhere that he went back blind? That leper, does the Bible ever tell us that his leprosy come back? Oh, Jesus changed him. He healed him. He touched him. He's still in the same business today. One change I can see in some. They're not perfect. I'm not perfect. We know that. We should never use it for our excuse to sin. But some I can see a change in them. They may not be one different in everything. According to the Scripture, you don't have to be. God works on us. It's a sanctification process, eh? I wasn't perfect when I got saved. He changed me and a lot of things in my life He took away. But if you'll notice that verse, I quoted it wrong for years. 1 Corinthians 5:17, 2 Corinthians 1. Word of that. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. For years I would quote from the pulpit, all old things are passed away. Behold, all things are made new. He quickened me one night while I was preaching and said, read that when you get home. I said, Lord, I've quoted that verse for years. I know it's on my heart. I went home, I read it. You know what He showed me? It does not say all of it. It says, old things are passed away. Behold, all things are made new. You know, when I got saved, I'm truly born again. He took a lot of things from me. But they were some things that I had to work on. And I'm still having to work on today with His saved. I'm a fleshly creature. The Holy Spirit lives inside of me. He is my guide. He is my teacher. He is my help. He is my friend. He is my convictor. He is the chastiser. He reproves me, rebukes me. He's working on me. But no, I'm still not And when you read the scripture and Jesus said, be ye therefore perfect as I am perfect, when you study into that word perfect, that does not mean without sin, because we'll never be without sin until we're like Him with a glorified body. But in that life, in this life, what that is teaching us is to be mature in our Christianity. When you study into that word, to be mature in our Christianity. And that's what we need to be. We don't need to go around patting people on the back for sin. Amen. Trying to act like they're all right. We need to be mature in our Christianity and grow and be a light to people around us instead of trying to still fit in and make everybody feel comfortable. We can do that in love. But so many people, I see two extreme sides of Christianity today. I see the liberal Christian. And they want all the love without any of the truth of the Word. And then I see the legal Christian. And they want to add all these things that you've got to do. But the truth is, you've got to find yourself somewhere right there in the middle. Maybe even a little bit more on the legal side. To where you love God's Word so much that you're not going to bend on it. You're not going to compromise with a world that's dying and going to hell. You're going to be a light to them. But yet you love that world and you love that sinner like Christ loved that sinner. And you pray for them and you try to speak the truth to them in love and you tell them and you make a difference. What thank you, Christ? I promise you I've seen people do it for a long time on the liberal side and never make a difference. I've seen people do it on the legal side with little churches sitting with five people, and most of the time it's their husband and wife and two kids or three kids in there. Hey, man, might have one family because they're so bad blame legalistic about everything. Hey, stuff's in that book and I don't teach you because I don't think you're ready for it. Well, I've been in church for 30 years. Get your nose in this book. Start living like it. Amen. God help us to love one another. God help us to be a mouthpiece for Jesus. God help us to be saved and know we're saved. You can know it today. You can have the assurance and the peace of your salvation. Make your peace calling and election sure. Know it. Paul said, I know in whom I have believed. There's things we put a lot more into than we do our walk with God. What think ye of Christ? Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Reflect back on your week. Reflect back on your week. Outside of church, how many times have you mentioned the Lord? In your home. At your work. Out in town. In public. On Facebook. With a friend. Think back. On your week. What have you done for Christ this week? Something outside of the normal. I'm not talking about while I went to church. God ever move your heart to do anything this week for Him? How much prayer time, how much time in the Word have we spent with God in the last week, in the last month, in the last year? Well, thank you, Christ. Our actions speak louder than our words. Louder than our words. God help us. Oh, Peter jumped up with a bold statement. Can't come get a song. He said, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. You know what Jesus told him? He said, Blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonas, for flesh and blood hath not revealed this unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. It is only through the Holy Ghost that we can truly confess Christ. And I'm talking about the seasoning on it. I'm talking about with a real unction. I'm talking about with some power behind it. That's what Peter done that day. He said, flesh and blood hath revealed this, hath not revealed, but my Father which is in heaven. Some things are only given of God through the Spirit. Through the Spirit. Through the Spirit. God help us today. Examine ourselves. Examine our hearts. Examine our lives. And ask ourselves. Well, thank you, Christ. Who do men around you say that he is? Do you have enough knowledge of this word to tell them, no, that's not biblical, that's not right. This ain't a popular book today. When they come off with their ideas and their secular Jesus teachings, do we have enough God about us to say, no, that's not right. I'm sorry, the Bible don't teach that. Well, thank you, Christ. Thank you, Peter. If anybody today has a need, whatever it may be, you bring it to God. Here this morning, if you need to be saved, if God has spoke to your heart, come to this altar. Bow on your knees and call upon Jesus and profess the Lord. Ask Him into your heart. Ask Him to forgive you of your sins. Ask Him to save you. I believe with all my heart, if the Spirit of God brought you to that place, I believe He'll do it. You mind the Lord as they sing. Come, Lord, as we bow in your presence, I come before you right now as humbly, God, as I know that. For I love you, God. Yes, Lord, help us, God. Oh, God, I pray my will be done. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray, God, that you'd save our people. If He's your Savior, is He your Lord, or are you still living your life? To the fulfillment and satisfaction of your flesh. I would talk about walking in the Spirit, not fulfilling the lust of the flesh. God, help us to walk in the Spirit. Mind the Lord. Young people, you need God. I'm going to give you some advice. You don't realize right now how bad you need God. I hear you. But you need God. There's a wicked world that wants to get its claws in you. Our youngins need God. We want to beg God and plead for their salvation and for the walk of the Lord and that they'd serve God and live for God all the days of their life and not make the mistakes that we've made. Not go down the roads and the paths that we have. Oh, help us to humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. Grab a hold of the Lord to the altar and pray with a fervency like we have in a long time. We need God. America needs God. Our churches need God. We've left Him out of the formula. We sing a few songs. We have a weak message. We have an altar call with no movements. Say, well, it's so good to be back today. My God, if we've lost our vertical lives and they sit amongst us and we can't cry out and pray for their soul, that covenant says we're to religiously seek the salvation of our kindred and our acquaintances. We need a burden. You've got a lost friend right now. You know they're lost. You know they've never been saved. They might tell you they are. Like I used to do to get them. Get you
y'all for life. But I pray you go down in your heart the way they talk, the way they walk, the places they go, the things they do. They have no desire for God. They never go to the house of God. They make every excuse and use every excuse. My friend, they're lost. And they need to be saved. They're your friend. God's put them in your life to make a difference in theirs. But you're so weak in your Christianity. You're so weak in your thinking of Christ that you're not making a difference. You're like Lot down there in Sodom and Gomorrah. Hey, you're being an ineffective Christian. You let that place have more effect on you than you have on them. Lot had to sit outside the gate. It was so wicked. The Bible says he thinks he's righteous soul from day to day. My friends, I'm telling you, we need a people that will rise up. A people that will serve God. A people that will walk with God with a righteousness as bold as a lion. A people that will love the Lord with all their heart. A people that will speak His name. A people that will shed tears for a lost and dying world. A people that will say, this ain't right. The Bible says this. God help us. God help us. God help us. You mind the Lord today. Mind the Lord. Lost person, come and be saved before it's everlasting too late. If God's filled with you, it ain't hard. You put your faith and trust in Him. You believe He died for you. Yes, He'll save you. He loves you. He wants to save you. It's not God's will that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. My friend, it's you that's keeping you from being saved. Come and humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. Cry and say, Lord, I'm a sinner. Lord, I need you in my heart. God, save my soul. Won't you come? Won't you come? Mind the Lord. Father, Lord, as we bow before you here this morning, God, one more time, Father, I don't have. God, I'm praying, Lord. Oh, God, we need your power, Father, to shake us, Lord. God, we need to get real with this thing. Quit playing hide and seek with the devil and the world. Quit trying to be friends with everybody. And worry about being a friend with Christ. Lord, I pray today. Oh, God. Lord, I pray you help us, Father. I pray you fill us with your spirit. I pray you use us for your glory. Lord, I pray God, put that drawing pile in this place. Lord, I pray you bring them in. Bring them into the fold. Help them, God. Oh, won't they come? Won't they come? Won't they come? Come to Jesus.
I'm a child.
Help that faith. Oh, my.
Never had my own nobody looking around. I'm going to make it real easy for you. You're standing on your feet. Nobody's looking. Lost person, I want you right now to step out. Take that person's hand beside you. Grab a hold of them. Say, will you go pray with me? Come to this altar. If you need me to guide you in the Word of God, if you need me to pray with you, I will. But I can't pray for you. Salvation's between you and God. Come and call on Jesus. Step out right now. Run to this altar. Won't you come? I'm the Lord. Don't die and go to hell. Don't you do it. Not in a service like this. Not when God spoke. Not when God's moving. Not when you're hearing the Spirit, the voice of God speaking to you. Lost person, don't you do it. You come to God. You'll be able to sing this song if you get saved.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I'm a child of the King. His royal blood now flows in my veins. And I feel the friendship.
Find the Lord, Mary Beth.
God,
I'm the Lord.
I'm a child of the King.
I love these young.
crying babies all over the service and the preacher started it preaching at me.
I'm telling you,
it's like grief. Sometimes I'm in church 7 nights a week. I've seen it happen, I don't know how many times. It's like grief. The devil tried to distract you and get your mind off of what God's saying. He wants you to go to hell with him for all eternity. But Jesus has his hand stretched out, saying, why don't you come? Why don't you be saved? If the spirits are wrong, you run to this altar.
Oh, yes. I'm a child of the King. His royal blood now flows in my veins, and I, who was wretched and poor,
sin, but only from sin. Then you're going to be a bondage to Christ.
for eternity, where you're going to be in bondage to serve Him. But right now, you are bound. You're bound in hell if you're not born again. That's just all there is to it.
Yes.
But you're always going to be a slave.
Oh,
who are you
going
to be a slave to? I'm going to be a slave to Christ.
Amen! Woo! Well, hey, Lisa. Hey, we're both talking.
Sorry.
No, that's fine. You didn't talk, she didn't talk.
Sorry.
Go ahead, Lisa.
Huh?
Go ahead. We didn't hear you text Tommy.
Oh, okay. I just want to thank the Lord for letting me be here today.
Yeah.
I'm just like everybody
was
praying for me,
God.
Yeah, bless
you all. God brought me through it. Thank God, thank God. Now, people, I want to ask you something. I'm serious this I can be. Do you got a testimony? Do you know you're saved? If you don't, it's something you better be really thinking hard about. Young people, look at you. Don't look down, don't look around. You look right here, look me in the eye. Right now. Do you know you're saved? I want our young people, this is too serious thing. I want our young people. I want them to do like I did, man. Young people, do you know you're saved? We're praying for you. We love you. It's our heart's desire and it's God's desire for you to be saved. I know right now you think your parents is dumb, you think this old preacher is dumb. One day you're going to realize that we love you. We're telling you the truth. If you'll ever truly get born again right with God, you'll realize, man, it's the best thing that's ever happened to you. You'll get saved while you're young. God stopped dealing with you. You'll live for God. You'll not have all these old regrets. I wish I wouldn't have done that. Boy, that was stupid. I wish I wouldn't have went tired. It'll be so much better.